I think we're going to change the rules of the game. I think that's what's going to happen. And I think that's what has to happen from my vantage point. One of the things that's beautiful about ecological economics is that there are so many different vantage points. And I think that's probably also part of the struggle of the discipline.
We are part of a very long, complex evolutionary process or co-evolutionary process with other species and with this planet. And so we need to ground ourselves in the sort of overwhelmingly widely accepted evolutionary paradigm of current science.
I think it was serendipity, honestly. I didn't start out pursuing or desiring to know more about ecological economics. It kind of came to me.
I grew up in a very wild place in southwestern Wyoming, and I had parents who were very close to the earth. And so I had this kind of environmental consciousness, I think, from the very start.
I grew up in Schenectady, New York, and my family lived in a house that was near the American Locomotive Company factory. But it also turned out that behind our house was the Union College Arboretum, and there was a gate between our house and the Arboretum. And so as a young boy, I spent a lot of time in the Arboretum, and I formed a profound affection and love for nature.
While at that time I couldn't find out much about ecological economics, from what I could glean from the few pieces that were out there, it was about the things that I had studied in undergrad to some degree, kind of taking them to the next level.
I grew up in the rural South, actually, in Arkansas, and remember my childhood was just all spent outdoors, you know, just exploring the woods and going out with friends, and it was just sort of central to my existence early on.
As an undergraduate, I went to Ghana on an exchange trip when I was in my second year of undergraduate. And that was the first time I had been to the Global South. I was studying public and international affairs, and so I kind of knew intellectually that I was interested in global inequality.
I didn't know that something called ecological economics existed until much later, probably in the 1980s sometime. And then I'd already started working on feminist economics, looking at how things associated with women had been neglected in mainstream economics.
In the early 1980s, the human ecologist Paul Shepard, who was my stepfather, gave me a copy of Herman Daly's book, Steady State Economics. And that really kind of reoriented my thinking.
It struck me immediately that nature and women have gotten similar treatment. They're supposed to be self-perpetuating while invisibly supporting the so-called economic system of markets and business.
Ecological economics has existed as a discipline, as a, you know, something that people can name and talk about and have conferences about and have a journal about since 1989, 1990. The society itself and the journal started around 89, 90, early 90s. In that time, I would say the phrase ecological economics has become known. I think that most social scientists know what that means, that it's about the limits of the economy and how the economy is in fact a subsystem of a materially closed, energetically open Earth ecosystem.
In the sort of 70s and early 80s, 1980s, I came to the view that the current economic system, the so-called progress system and growth system, was destroying the things that I loved the most. I was very drawn to what I think is the self-evident idea that the economy is embedded in and part of Earth's biogeochemical systems. That seemed to me to be completely uncontroversial.
If you asked a simple question of economic theory, what would you be like if you were connected to contemporary science? That launches you into ecological economics. Right? But ecological economics itself, I think, hasn't really taken hold of the sort of radical metaphysical difference that makes. The whole edifice of many of the social normative social sciences collapses, and ecological economics was sort of got a little beachhead over here, but
I can tell you the image of ecological economics from the outside is radically different from what it actually is. From the outside, it appears to be sort of a critique shop of economics, pointing out all the bad assumptions that are on it. But actually, it's about what you described. It's essentially evaluating and understanding and using that understanding of social ecological systems, of the knitting together of society, of economic systems, and of ecological systems.
One of the things that I've always really loved about ecological economics is how it's a big tent. There's room for theoreticians, there's room for practitioners, and people who are very interested in, you know, applied numbers and, you know, integrating economic stuff and biology. There's room for activists, and there's room for visionaries, right? People who are going to create and spin the webs of words that allow us all to see a positive way into the future. Ecological economics has raised a lot of the technical issues, and there are so many applications for that understanding in policy, but we see a little bit of a disconnect, right? We have so many solutions that are kind of, you know, plug and play, ready to go. We know what we need to do, but we're not seeing it widely adapted. And so for me, that's where these social issues come in, like issues of power and who decides and who has the ownership of various parts of the economy.
Ecological economics, when I found it, was really about teaching ecology, teaching science, rooting economics in the natural sciences. That's where the field started in the 70s and in the 80s and into the 90s. And then it got a little bit co-opted by the kind of economic worldview. It got co-opted by this whole notion of thinking like an economist.
It seems like ecological economics has had over the last 20 years like this incredibly robust critique of neoclassical economics, and so you get the critique and it totally makes sense from a sort of intuitive level, a mathematical level, like on all these levels the critique works, and then you sort of get to the solutions part, and there are things out there, but I think as a society it's really hard to latch on to just a critique, you know what I mean? And I think that's maybe the reason ecological economics hasn't made more headway in mainstream economics. So
I think institutionally ecological economics is like someone who's in their early 20s trying to establish which of the beginning values and formative ideas are the ones we want to keep and carry forward, and which do we need to change, which need to be left behind altogether. So we've come through a period where we've tried to live within the world we're in, and I think that's led us down a road of not being clear about the differences between ecological economics and environmental economics. So the question of the use of neoclassical economics always comes up, and I really think that where we are right now is still trying to sort that out.
I think what's happened, though, is we've always tried to be a big tent to open our doors to others. A lot of people have recognized environmental problems, don't really understand there's this distinction between environmental economics, which is a subdivision of neoclassical economics, and ecological economics, which is really fundamentally different. But I have a very big fear that our ideas will become diluted, and that simply because there are way, way, way more environmental or conventional economists than our ecological economists, will just be diluted and kind of cease to exist.
Ecological economics has always had this transdisciplinary view, a very pluralistic view. And I think that's fine for methods. We want to be very pluralistic with our methods. We want to attack problems from lots of different disciplines. We want to let the problems define the knowledge and define the tools and define the disciplines that we need to help solve them. But I worry that we're kind of out there in a world of sort of pluralistic theory.
I think mainstream economics has gotten narrowed around one paradigm. Ecological economics maybe at this point kind of suffers from the opposite problem of having too many different ways of looking at things.
And I think we are at a really profound historical moment where what we're able to do in the next 20 years is going to make a huge difference.
Where ecological economics is going, or where it needs to go, I think, is to really start to hone in on a theory of the economy embedded in social cultural systems, embedded in ecosystems.
I actually think that there's going to be a sea change. The only question is, are we going to be able to actually convince people we need to operate our economic system differently before there's a collapse, so we have a smooth transition to a degrowth, smaller economy? Or is it going to be forced upon us by a collapse that we need to adapt to?
Frankly, I think that it needs to distinguish itself as coming up with solutions that are really alternatives to the dominant paradigm. The future of ecological economics is to be the creators, debaters, practitioners of all of the different ways of trying to organize ourselves to live in a sustainable way and to enhance life's quality for all, and not just humans, but the non-human aspects of the globe as well.
I think that fundamentally ecological economics is about innovation. It's innovating the whole framing of society and where the economy truly sits within the Earth system.
Ecological economics is great at diagnosing what's wrong with point A, where we are, and it's really good at envisioning point B.
Right.
I think we're very bad at practically moving towards point B. Coming of age, the unfinished journey, that I think would be a fantastic thing to kind of mature into.
Yeah.
Not just be the people who talk about what's wrong with A and what's better about B, but lead the way from A to B.
Ecological economics needs to feel more fully the burden of this historical moment. How we provide people with jobs and maintain the biophysical and ecological integrity of the planet at the same time.
The second major, I think, failing here is if you contrast the two elements of economics with ecological economics. Economics is concerned with growth and efficiency. Ecological economics should be concerned more with, the steady state, no growth, with the material basis of the economy, and to replace efficiency, equity.
Ecological economics changes her understanding of justice fundamentally, yeah, because it has put justice in the context of Earth's constraints. Mm-hmm. And most theories of justice, like John Rawls and so forth, going on through the centuries, haven't done that. So this is a radical change. I think Ellie's work on climate justice is a terrific example of that, right? How you have to look at the coupling between the kinds of outcomes you're talking about, our ethical systems, and the planetary systems. That all gets merged into one.
So in an unequal world, markets allocate resources to those who need them the least and who get less benefit from them. And I think for a long time, ecological economists have been focused on starting with the historical conditions. Here's where we are in market economy. How do we use that market economy to achieve our goals as we transition to something else? I think some of the breaks from that market economy may need to be more profound. And we really got to start looking at alternative ways of allocating resources outside of that if we can achieve that just distribution first.
It seems like two steps forward, one step back. I think that we need to cast our minds in more creative directions and more future-oriented directions.
We need to just scrap that and move on, not spend so much time criticizing it. It's just starting from scratch and building a new system.
We have to explicitly bring in the social side, I think. I see that as one of the coming future steps.
We really are at a moment where we need to rebuild, rethink, redesign, retool our economic systems. And the unfinished journey is to go back to the roots of ecological economics, to go back to our forefathers and foremothers of ecological economics, and reboot the enterprise.
You know, the mainstream has failed you know, both the environment and the human economy. And time to move on.
I think the world is arriving at the doorstep of ecological economics. And we have a chance to shift our footing from critiquing or appearing like we're critiquing all the time to actually leading and showing what could be done.
There was a movie a long time ago called Smokey and the Bandit. So it's the theme of the movie has got a long way to go and a short time to get there. So let's get trucking.